Ah, yes. It's that time of year again. That special time where we watch Christmas movies that make us nostalgic for a time gone by. Stories that warm our heart like a cup of cocoa. Or maybe we just want to watch an elf get bullied for wanting to be a dentist. No matter what the reason, we all have specials that are near and dear to our heart, despite their, imperfections. Anyone remember that part in Santa Claus is Coming to Town when Kris Kringle sang about how the orphan kids should sit in his lap and give him a kiss?
A little love! Get a little love back!
Cause I sure didn't. Put one foot in front of the other. While everyone has their own personal favorite specials, and all of them except for me are wrong, the one thing we can all agree on is that once this season passes, none of us will think of any of these movies until next November. For me, though, there's one Christmas tale that is just so potent, full of so many indescribable images, that it transcends the memory hole of December, and its scenes will frequently appear in my brain at any time of the year. That isn't even a joke for the video. It can be in the middle of July, and the line, "Nobody likes you, Booster," will just appear in my head. I'm of course talking about the historical drama, Jingle All the Way.
I'm gonna deck your halls, bub.
Now, you probably know what this movie is, or you don't. It stars Arnold himself, the star of hit films like Kindergarten Cop and Junior, and nothing else. This time, though, he won't simply have to battle children and the miracle of childbirth. Arnold will now have to deal with new terrors, suburbanite shoppers, Sinbad, and Phil Hartman trying to fuck his wife. We begin our Christmas film as all classics begin, like this.
It's Turbo Time!
In this world, the greatest character around is Turbo Man. He has a jetpack, he shoots these things, and he has a boomerang. He's not as cool as my favorite character, Booster, the pink cat thing. Sadly, this isn't the actual movie. It's simply a TV show that this kid is watching. Hey, I know that face. It's that kid all those nerdy man children bullied into having a drug addiction.
Jake Lloyd, where do I know that name?
If you couldn't tell, Turbo Man is kind of a combination of every cool superhero a kid would like, and also Power Rangers. 'Cause Power Rangers rocked. Anyway, it's Christmas time. Everyone is getting drunk and banging at the office Christmas party. It's just like the Puritans warned us about. But like a good Christian boy, we see the hero of our tale, Howard Langston, continuing on with his Protestant work ethic. The most unrealistic aspect of this entire movie is that this man's name is Howard Langston. He's Arnold. You know it. I know it. Arnold prioritizes work over everything else. Like Tom Brady. He has a history of pretty much missing every important event in his kid's life, and the ramifications of being an absent father are already being realized. The kid's a Marvel fan. Arnold decides that traffic is for wimps, and that he's a true stud, so he bypasses all of the traffic, cause he's
ballsy.
He doesn't stay stuck in traffic.
Like you.
Sorry you missed the karate class today, but don't worry, I got it all on video for you.
What would I do without you?
This movie is that classic dynamic of an overworked dad that ignores his family.
You didn't go last year, or the year before, but Mom and I always go.
What was so important on the other Christmases, Arnold? What do you actually do? Are you Santa? Were you the one that Tim Allen killed that fateful December morn? To make up for being a negligent father, Arnold whips out the oldest trick in the book, buy his son's affection. And even though Turbo Man is, like, literally this kid's entire personality, Arnold has to ask him again what he really wants for Christmas. It sure is a mystery. So yeah, there you go. That's the premise. Arnold has to get a very popular toy to make things up with his kid, and it just happens to be the most popular toy of the season.
Because at this point, they'd probably be impossible to find.
If you've ever had to bash someone's brain in for the opportunity to get a PS5, then you know perfectly well the plot of this movie. There's a limited stock, and it's survival of the fittest in this shopping hellscape. Now, I don't want to just recap what happens in Jingle All the Way, mainly because it's only an hour and a half, and the plot is incredibly simple. Like, it's just Arnold running around trying to get a doll, not getting that doll, and then running to the next objective to not get a doll. Now that I think about it, this is like the same basic plot Bethesda used for their Fallout games. Twice. This is a Christmas movie where everyone is an antagonist. In his quest for a Turbo Man doll, Arnold will have to face down a collection of challengers. In many ways, this is like John Wick or Scott Pilgrim, except not at all.
Do you want to trade? Huh? No, just give me the ball.
I got it. Ted the neighbor.
Ted is Arnold's neighbor. He's like Ned Flanders. If Ned Flanders openly f***ed every stay-at-home mom in town. And I mean openly.
Just doesn't seem to be working, and you being such a handyman.
Sure, I've got just the tool for the job.
Ted uses his handyman charm to swap recipes with every wife within a 5-block radius. All the lands have been conquered, all except for Arnie's wife. While Arnold wages away, Ted has been working to overthrow him from his own domain. Putting up the Christmas lights, eating the cookies.
Oh, these cookies! I gotta get the recipe from Les.
Put that cookie down! Now!
Even attempting to top Arnold's tree with a star. The audacity. Nothing is sacred to Ted. He'll invade your home, steal your woman. Ted is perfect for those wishing to play a stealth main. However, if you're aiming for strength, I would avoid him, considering he gets taken out by eggnog to the noggin.
That didn't exactly go as well as I'd hoped.
For that, I'm going to rate him a C-tier threat physically, but for his psychological damage, he's a solid A.
Sinbad.
Sinbad has a character name, but just like Arnold, I'm not gonna use that name. I don't even remember what he was called. He's Sinbad. So Sinbad is in the same spot as Arnold. He's a dad who has to get a Turbo Man for his kid too. They will now be the greatest enemies for the rest of the afternoon.
You dad! I got you!
Cosmic levels of fate have intertwined them, like Lost. Maybe it's because I have trash taste, but I think Sinbad's the best part of this movie.
Cause I work for the post office, so you know I'm not stable!
He has a pretty good dynamic with Arnold, who kinda just stands there and tolerates everything this crazy man says. Is that not the true spirit of Christmas? This is a true battle of minds, each side one-upping and foiling the other, but neither getting the ultimate prize. They're just two doofuses stuck in a problem of their own creation. In fact, my favorite part of this movie is when things slow down and they just talk in a diner.
But, of course, for my old man, Christmas was just another opportunity to let me down.
The Turbo Man dolls aren't the important thing in this. They're simply there to show that they listen to their kid.
Here's to you, Dad.
Which, let's be honest, Arnold does not listen to his kid. He wouldn't have needed to ask this kid what he wanted for Christmas in the first place if he did. Sinbad is equal to Arnold in all levels, except for speed. Mainly because he's so over-encumbered with loot. And as a mailman, he will on occasion use his packages for an advantage. Something I call an IED.
What's that?
This, Master Trackstar, is a homemade explosive device!
Because that's what it is. He pulls out an IED.
You build a bomb?
No, I didn't have to build a bomb. Don't you read the news? Hundreds of these things come through the mail every day.
But you know, it's a Christmas movie, so it has to be a bluff.
Ooh.
He even tries it a second time, wackily bamboozling all the police officers.
The holiday shoppers.
The world of Jingle All the Way is desperate and frantic. Arnold becoming another cog in the machine, joining to fight tooth and nail to get the hottest gift of the 1996 holiday season.
Pikachu! Pikachu!
Get the mailman!
What? No!
Get him!
Is this what John Capitalism envisioned when he first invented money in 1952? I don't think so. It's a force of nature that cannot be possibly defeated, but it can be controlled.
Retail employees.
The poor retail workers in Jingle All the Way are fighters of their own. They aren't simply stepped on by the crowd, though that does happen a lot. We see that they take avid enjoyment in the suffering of their customers. And I don't just mean laughing in Arnold's face because he doesn't know how popular Turbo Man is. I'm talking about how they smirk a little bit when people get angry.
The new list price on each figure just doubled.
What?
This shit is malicious.
The cop that suffers.
There's a cop that pops up throughout the film. He keeps getting caught up in Arnold's shenanigans from time to time. Now, the movie makes us want to think that this cop is the bad guy. But in my personal opinion, I think he's the hero. Because he was pulled over in the first place, Arnold was reminded that he needed to get the doll, and the events of the movie took place. If Arnold was actually on time to that karate event, Christmas Eve would have came and went, and then on Christmas morning, there wouldn't be a doll. So you know what? Thank you, nameless police officer. You saved this guy's marriage.
Howard.
But how does Arnold repay this man? He runs over his bike. He commits a terrorist act. And then finally treats him like a barista at Starbucks. Once again, the thin blue line has been destroyed by Christmas cheer.
Recite the alphabet.
A, B, C.
Backwards.
The Santa Cartel.
A local mall Santa overheard that Arnold was in a bit of a predicament and has a certain offer for him.
That was taken this morning.
Nothing weird about that. So they all travel in Arnold's car down to the weird warehouse. It's like the start of a horror movie.
I know what you're thinking.
Oh no. You have no idea.
Honestly, I think Arnold is taking this a bit too lightly. A bunch of grown men in a warehouse outside of town, all dressed identically the same. This is a cult. In a shocking twist, the shady Santas sell Arnold a broken Turbo Man. Arnold goes on this movie's equivalent of the church scene from Kingsman. After breaking into Ted's house and desecrating his idols, everyone agrees to leave Arnold behind as they go to the big Christmas parade. Turbo Man's gonna be there. Arnold tried to steal a child's present and punched a reindeer, so he doesn't get to go see Turbo Man.
You can't bench press your way out of this one.
The all is lost moment in this movie lasts probably like 2 minutes. Arnold drinks his beer, collects himself, and goes to the parade to win back his family. A series of wacky circumstances later, and he's stuck in a rubber suit against his will. Much like an M. Night Shyamalan twist, Arnold was actually Turbo Man the entire time. I've always loved the climax of this movie. Arnold goes from absolutely loathing this dumb superhero to fully accepting it. And I mean, how can you not? Listen to that soundtrack. This random Christmas parade in Minneapolis puts the Macy's Thanksgiving one to shame. It's almost like Turbo Man was a conquering hero, a modern-day Caesar. When I was a kid, I thought all parades were like this. I was in for a disappointment. Through sheer dumb luck and the magic of rushing to the finale, this bumbling fool has found himself dressed as his son's favorite character. Much like the time my dad dressed up as my favorite character, Big Bird, and gave me a surprise. Because this man couldn't possibly do anything himself, the universe bestows upon him a Turbo Man, right in front of him. This is certainly the nostalgia talking, but I always remembered the events of this movie being longer and more impactful. So every time I would watch this as a kid, and he would finally get the doll, I don't know why, it would just feel so satisfying. Like I was making up for being neglectful to my son. This is the Christmas version of Frodo reaching Mount Doom. His son finally gets the doll, but much like Return of the King, there's one last challenge. Something I call Sinbad Requiem. He is now so powerful, he can push the boundaries of a PG rating. Upon killing Booster and leaving him to die at the hands of the local youth, Sinbad fights Arnold one-on-one for the doll. These were made for a Christmas parade, right? This is a battle truly for the ages.
Ta-ta! Turtle Man.
Who installed the weapons? Did they just make actual power armor? All for a kid's show? Through the rejection of Sinbad, Arnold has broken this man. he has now resorted to committing a lot of felonies. He's really lucky that Arnold was there to save the kid from falling to his death, or this wacky Christmas adventure would have ended with a much different tone. Despite almost never making it to the double digits in age, Arnold's kid instantly forgives his almost murderer for all that child endangerment stuff, showing that this wasn't just about the doll, it was about the friends we made along the way.
But Jamie, I thought you wanted this doll more than anything.
What do I need the doll for? I got the real Turbo Man at home!
That is so damn corny. I love it.
I'm going to jail!
That's cute and all. My main question now is, what is the kid actually going to get for Christmas? An ever-present father figure is a good gift and all, but that's more of an intangible relationship concept, you know? So, did Arnold get him anything else? Is his child just content now that his dad won't abandon him? I guess sometimes the greatest victories are just barely meeting the lowest of expectations. Sure, when school comes around, he won't have his neat toy to show off, but at least he can look his bullies right in the face and say this universe's equivalent of "My dad works at Nintendo."
About? Just a sick world we're living in, sick people!